When I began to hear the voice of the Holy Spirit, I have not started prophesying. I was in the realms of the word of knowledge. I was in the realms of the word of knowledge. Just hearing cases. And one day the Lord was talking to me, said, Johnson, my prophet. I was looking for who called me. Because I was not a prophet. If Reverend Kingsley will remember, we had the prophetic. I don't know if you're in that program. Were you in the program in CGM Okpa? I went to one time. You were there. That was when the prophetic came. They actually invited somebody big that didn't show up. I was to handle a morning session. And the thing came. I just had something, I had a name, the person ran out. It was just happening. To me, it was like, what's going on? The person comes out, I hear something, I say, it's true. I say, it's true. And I told myself, they say, you handle evening session. So I called the pastor. I said, that thing that happened was a mistake. It was a mistake. I don't know how that thing happened. No. He said, no problem. Make the mistake again this evening. Climbed the pulpit with fear because the whole place, the window everywhere was jammed. I climbed the pulpit with fear. I could stay three hours, 2 hours. Then there's someone here, describe what you are wearing, do all that, but not calling names, calling streets. As I was worshiping God, that's what worship does. It takes away fear, it takes away your humanity and gives expression to divinity. Evening was worse, powerful. And the pastor and his wife came to me in the evening with a pen and a paper. I said, what is this, sir? He said, tell us what God is saying about us. I said, I said, sir, that thing that I'm going to tell you the truth. Even when I got to the, not the hotel, we stayed in one house, one member's house. When I got to that room, I was still asking myself, what is going on? My whole desire that day was how to leave that town. So, because they are now knowing me for what I don't know myself for, let me go to where they know me for what I am. The next day, he said, you have to do a very quick session with pastors. I said, sir, that thing that is happening, I'll be honest with you. Why? Because I didn't know. If it doesn't happen, let me tell you. I told you. Among the pastors, boom. I said, this thing is sweet. I told myself, I said, this thing is sweet. This is sweet. I just continued like that. And I left the village. I said, Father, thank you. I'm not going there again. We started the program from Tuesday. Our program, there used to, you know, we had no agenda. Our program used to be long, Tuesday to Sunday. Scatter our head there. Scatter ourselves. And at the end of it, I got back. The pastor told somebody, he said, what we saw, invite him. I didn't know that there was an expectation. 2 weeks after that, I went somewhere and they called it the prophetic. When I saw the program, I said, I'm not going. Because if you don't have it in abundance, don't raise up people's appetite for it. What you don't have in abundance, don't raise up people's appetite for it, because you have to keep satisfying. Continuously, there are people, no matter how I preach, no matter the depth of revelation, they will write one thing. They are waiting for prophecy. They never open their mouth during the word, during prophecy. Jesus, now wow. Am I communicating? I stumbled into it. There was nothing like I fasted. I stumbled. I liked it, but I stumbled. When it came, the problem, now the crisis became how to maintain it. Am I communicating now?
I hope you were blessed just as I was. The title of the message is, What God Has Written. He has written, based on what the Restoration Apostle said. The gift of prophecy accidentally dropped on him while he was going about his father's business. Do you desire the gift of prophecy and want it at all cost? Then here are ways to access it. Here are six simple keys to receive the gift of prophecy. Number one, pursue love, desire the gift. Pursue love and earnestly desire the spiritual gifts, especially that you may prophesy. 1 Corinthians chapter 12 verses 5. Now I want you all to speak in tongues, but even more to prophesy. Number two, stay in prayer and communion with God. People prefer the prophetic being taught, but the truth is that it is supposed to be caught. Synchronize your heart with the heart of God and you will hear His voice. For no prophecy was ever produced by the will of man, but men spoke from God as they were carried along by the Holy Spirit. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 21. Number 3, gifts imparted by the laying of hands. Do not neglect the spiritual gift you received through the prophecy spoken over you when the elders of the church laid their hands on you. 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 14. Number 4, must fan it consistently. Soaking in God, using it often, learning about it, being accountable with it. For this reason I remind you to fan into flame the gift of God, which is in you through the laying on of my hands. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 6. Number 5, by association. Anointing rubs by association, just like faith is caught. I encourage you all to read the story of Elijah and Elisha. Number 6, practice being conscious of His voice consistently. Pray that the Lord would open your spiritual eyes and ears to hear His voice. He is always speaking, but it is our duty as believers to be sensitive and to seek Him with all our hearts. God bless you. And always remember, Jesus Christ is Lord.